The only shoes that come with this awesome communicator.
Tools look real. Cool tools.
Hello. It's Patrick. He took out life insurance.
Scott Goslin and Dick Assman, formerly of Northgate Petro, have relocated to Victoria Square. Now, folks, I know that it's not fair to make fun of somebody's name, but good heavens. Goslin? Paul, do you have anything for this?
Absolutely. Tony, hit it.
Northgate Petro Canada. Whoa, they're relocating. Their new office at Victoria Square. They're celebrating. Whoa, via con Dios, Dick Assman. Via con Dios.
So, can you please introduce yourself and tell me where you're from?
I'm Dick Assman from Regina, Saskatchewan. D-I-C-K-A-S-S-M-A-N.
Okay. What do you do for a living?
I was on the farm for a while until I was 21, then I moved to Regina. Then I worked for the co-op for 8 years. And after that, I went on my own for 26 years. At a Petro-Canada station. Well, it was a BA before, and then it was golf, and then it was Petro-Canada.
Dick, you have a super interesting name, a unique name. Can you tell me a little bit about the origin of your last name?
Oh, I don't know. We used to say it's Assman, but he changed to Assman, so.
Who changed it? To Assman.
Dave Letterman.
David Letterman.
Dick Assman. Dick Assman.
Dick Assman.
Assman, the gas man.
Dick Ass.
Dick
Assman.
Dick
Assman.
Dick
Assman. Dick Assman. All right, Dick Assman.
Dick Assman.
Dick Assman. Dick Assman.
Dick, there's Dick Assman up there in Canada.
So, kind of walk me through exactly what happened that summer to you.
Well, I was working at the service station, and on my day off, I used to go to McDonald's for coffee, and that morning I got a phone call from the service station that Dave Letterman wants to talk to me. And he wanted to know if it was okay if he can use my name, and I said, yeah, no problem. So, but he kept on phoning almost every day, and I never ever listened or watched Dave Letterman. I told that to my boss, I don't even know who he is, you know. But the boss knew who he was. He told me he's got big shows and stuff like that, and he's in New York, so.
Were you watching the show after that, I imagine?
Oh, I was watching.
Yeah? Sure. Did you see Tony Orlando's musical tribute too?
Oh, that was great, I enjoyed that.
Yeah?
Yeah, that's good.
Do you remember how the song goes?
Sort of, yeah. Yeah, it was great, it was good.
Can you sing any of the song?
No.
How did you feel with that?
Oh, feel like you're in heaven.
Yeah. Were you a Tony Orlando fan before that?
I didn't know him before either. You know.
Was every time a surprise that he contacted you?
Well, yeah, sure. Well, it was just on pretty well every day. Hey, you know, it was a surprise, I read. He just kept on cutting phone.
We thought tonight, if we have a second, we'll just call and spend a minute or two here on the show getting to know Dick Assman. Here we go. Saskatchewan, I believe. I think Victoria Square, is that what it says? This should be somebody at Petro-Canada, Victoria Square, Petro-Canada. We're looking for Dick Assman. Scott Goslin.
Petro-Canada, Victoria Square Service. Scott speaking.
Oh, Scott, how are you? My name's Dave Letterman. Are you Scott Goslin?
Yes, I am.
Scott, it's a pleasure to chat with you on the phone. How are things there at the service station today?
Just great. Just booming.
Uh-huh. You know, the reason we're calling, Scott, we want to speak to your co-worker, or is it your partner?
Yeah, he's a co-worker here.
All right. Is Dick Assman?
Yes, yes. Yes.
I tell you, Scott, we would love to talk to you, but your name's not silly enough, so if you don't mind, if you could put Dick on the phone, we'd certainly appreciate it.
Could you hold the line a minute?
Yeah, I'd be happy to. I'm not doing anything else. Just waiting to pick up my laundry, Scott. Take all the time you need.
Hello.
Hello, who is this?
Dick Assman.
Oh, Dick! Dick, my name is Dave Letterman. It's a pleasure to chat with you, sir. How are you today?
Real good, real good.
You know, Dick, last night on our television show, The Late Show here on CBS, we featured a little ad for you and your service station, and we made some jokes about your name. I hope you don't mind.
No, I sure don't.
It's kind of an unusual name, though, isn't it?
Just like to know how you got a hold of it.
Yeah. Well, I think we can tell by looking at the photo how you got a hold of it, Dick. Dick?
61.
And Dick, tell us a little bit about what life is like up there. Are you in Saskatchewan?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And what do you do for fun?
Well, I like horse races.
Uh-huh.
And I watch a lot of football and baseball and that.
Yeah? Well, there you go. You can't do any better than that, Dick. Well, will you do us a favor and keep in touch?
Okay.
And again, you pronounce your name how?
Assman.
Assman. All right. Thank you very much, Dick. Nice chatting with you.
Okay.
Bye-bye.
How and why did he contact you there?
Well, I guess he seen an ad in the paper, because I used to have my own station that. And then when I moved over to the Victoria Square there, I told the boss, I said, I know a lot of people. I said, let's put an ad in the paper. So he put it in the paper, and I guess that's where he got a hold of it.
Were you expecting the kind of the attention that you gained from that particular advertisement? Were you expecting Letterman and
no,
kind of what happened over the summer
no,
from
sure
there on
didn't.
Out?
I had no idea at all.
When the show was just in its first couple segments on TV, were people starting to recognize you?
Oh, that's for sure, yeah. He phoned in a few days, you know, and then people were coming in, and CTV was there a lot, and it was really going pretty good then, eh?
Did that celebrity kind of change how you were living at the time?
Nope, it never changed. No, I never.
No, you were still...
Still got my same friends and everything. No, I never.
You didn't feel like you couldn't go to the grocery store or something like that?
Oh, no. I still go.
So what did that whole sensation feel like?
Well, feels okay if they think that much of you, I guess.
So with all this attention you were receiving, was it kind of something you wanted?
Well, I don't mind that. Drop the beat.
We are live at the home of Dick Assman.
Thank you so much.
Dick Assman!
How old were you when that all was taking place?
61 years old.
61, eh? So did you think at the age of 60 you were going to be propelled to... your celebrity would be propelled so high?
I sure didn't, no, that's for sure.
So as we were kind of talking before about while we were taking a break, how do you look the exact same 20 years later?
I don't know. That's what everybody tells me, you haven't changed.
Did you keep the stress out of your life?
Oh, sure. I've been feeling good. I've yet to miss one day off of work. Since 61, I've worked every day, never sick one day.
Well, that's
That's a long time.
Yeah, I guess so.
So you do get a couple days off a week now,
yeah,
right?
Yeah. Sometimes not even work overtime.
So what makes you keep coming back into work?
Well, I never did retire, really. But I got nothing to do. You know, live in an apartment by myself. Better off working.
And you must like working.
I do. I love it.
Yeah. What's your favorite thing about working?
Well, meeting all the people, all the time, you know. You always talk about this, talk about that. You know that little sign up there that if you know Dick Ass or something, blow your horn, the horns are blowing all day.
So what do you think would be the best route to go over here to get to the former site, the Petrocan?
I don't know, I've never been on there since I left there.
No?
No. Boy, this sure changed. I haven't been here since they built all this stuff here.
Looking a little different?
Oh, I guess so.
Where was the building?
The
Petrocan.
Oh, it's over on the other side, yeah.
On the other side of the street?
Yeah, on this side of the building here.
This is the corner. Was it kind of like right where this building is?
Yeah. Then there was a service station where there's pumps on each side.
In relation to where the building was, where were all the pumps and everything?
Just, they were about, let's say, about 40, 50 feet in from the lights here.
Where did you guys have, like, the Dick Assman is here sign?
Right in the corner there by the lights there.
Like right up against the light?
Yeah. Well, they're on this side of the street, you know.
How many people do you think drive by here still and still think?
They're still probably looking for the sign.
So it was at this location that the ambassador for New York came?
Yeah. Right by the corner there. Right, we took a picture right with the sign and everything. I got that on there at home there, got the picture.
Yeah.
He's pretty good. Just about top guy there.
And he came just to see you?
Yeah, that's right.
How everything's changed now, how do you feel with being back here for the first time in a while?
Well, I don't really miss it because the other one's pretty well the same, you know, same work. Yeah.
So what kind of memories do you have from this area?
Well, just come to work every day.
Yeah. Well, you got to come to work every day, but then you also ended up on a national television.
Yeah, no, that's right. If I wouldn't have moved here, it probably never happened, eh?
Yeah.
That's right. Take that. It's unbelievable how they can build all this stuff like that, hey? No?
Yeah.
Unbelievable.
Yeah, they put it up quick.
Yeah, they sure do.
So you get a little nostalgic of seeing this place 20 years later?
Yeah, that's something.
So how about all this out here? Was this all built on the other side of the street?
Costco was there. And there used to be a turbo station on the corner here. Across the street.
They were competition?
Yeah. Oh yeah, this is it. What a difference, hey? The station was in about here. Right by the doors there, you know.
Yeah. So how big was the service station?
Well, they had about two, had about eight pumps.
Eight pumps?
Yeah.
So it was a decent size. Decent size service station.
Oh, yeah. Well, it was busy. especially after they Redmond phoned. Boy, oh boy.
Yeah.
A couple of guys were going to quit because it was too busy.
When you'd come into work, would you still be trying to do all your duties and like sign autographs and stuff all at the same
time? Well, a lot of days I didn't do anything except sign autographs.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
And the boss was cool with that?
Oh, he didn't care. He didn't care because he was making money.
Everybody should have a Dick Aspin t-shirt. It's a thing now. It's something for Regina to be proud of.
Dick, can you tell me about some of the public appearances you made during that time?
Well, I was on TV there when they did the weather forecast.
Where was that from?
Channel 5.
STV?
Yeah.
It was STV at the time.
Yeah. Like I say, I went to Mushev to throw that first pitch. Well, that was great. That was okay. Went down with a limousine. And I wrestled Bret Hart one day.
Yeah.
At Big Big Square there.
So he's a little uptight, a little nervous, but we'll see what's going to go on in a couple of minutes. So let's just, how many here are cheering for the Ass Man? Yeah! How many are here to cheer for the Hit Man? Yeah! Well, I tell you right now, it is going to be a very tight competition here.
I don't know how they got it all set up, but they asked me if I'd want to wrestle him, so.
So it's the Assman versus the Hitman.
That's right.
I'd like to introduce to you, from Calgary, Alberta, weighing 235 pounds, he is the excellence of execution, Rick the Hitman Hart.
Were you a fan of the Hitman Hart?
Oh yeah, I love him, yeah.
Gentlemen,
would you please welcome the challenger from Regina, Saskatchewan, weighing 225 pounds, the Ass Man. Well, we were all in a different rooms, and then we both walked up there. And
the way this is going to work, we are going to have an arm wrestling championship. It will be one match only, to decide who is the best. The Hitman?
Yeah!
The Ass Man?
Bret Hart, it was great.
You know, pumping gas gives him a lot of strength with his hands. But I'm not going to let that intimidate me. No, I see Dick give me the evil eye. But I'm not a person that scares easy, Dick.
I flipped him.
Two! The Ass Man in an upset! What happened in that one? That was so fast!
You just took him out.
Now there's the winner. Let the Hitman Hart begin with us.
I swallowed hard when it was over, and I was just glad that I'm able to stand here right now and talk about it.
Well, and that you're alive.
Yeah.
I beat him, so I was number one. And then he took us all out for supper after that, and it was great.
You gotta be a big man to take on the Ass Man. Ass Man? You got this, a little presentation to Brett. It's the Ass Man soft seat thing there. So if that combo's a little too hard and you ever suffer from hemorrhoids, you got that to take care of you, Brett. From the Ass Man.
With more goops to choose from, Master Kenneth has perfected the art of bugging people.
Pardon me, but do you have any Grey Poupon?
But of course.
Tonight, ladies and gentlemen, it's time for another Dick Ass Man update. Here we go. We've known this mild-mannered Canadian for almost a month now, and we thought we would share with you, some of the highlights of that relationship. Watch this.
Whoa!
I had a dream, I had an awesome dream. People in the park, playing games in
got Dick Ass Mania. Be a Dick Ass Maniac.
It was on August 18th, 1995. When he phoned, he wanted to know if I'd come down, and he set it all up. We flew down there. Everything was first class. And he picked me up with a limousine in New York there. And the hotel was something else. Forget what the name of the hotel was, but it was beautiful. It's only about a block away from the where the show was.
How about now a nice, warm American welcome for Dick Assman. Dick?
Well, it was something like, you can't believe what you go through when that goes on. You know, it's...
Come on out!
For about an hour at the most. They put me in the basement, and they said that they'll come and call me when I'm ready to go, hey? And then all of a sudden, two women come along. Oh, I really wasn't that nervous, really. You know.
No?
Pretty calm, yeah.
Welcome to the Late Show. Here we have a little something for you, Dick.
Oh, thanks very much.
Do you have anything you'd like to say?
Well, it's a great feeling. Great to be on your show.
Are you enjoying yourself?
I sure am.
What are you doing this weekend?
Probably go home.
Probably go home. Did you hear that, ladies and gentlemen? He'll probably go home. Dick, thanks for all your help. It's been great fun knowing you. Enjoy yourself back in Canada. Thank you for everything.
Thanks very much.
There you go, Dick. Dick Assman, ladies and gentlemen.
That was it. I never met any other big stars or anything there. No. I wasn't really on the stage that long, but it was something.
Well, I just was hoping that everything would go great. You know, don't make too many mistakes. Don't know what's going to happen from now on. As far as I'm concerned, I don't think that's the end yet.
Did you know it was going to be how it was, like you escorted
no,
out?
No, I didn't know anything. He never said anything about what he's going to do or anything, nothing. Just the girl took me out there, and everything what he did was new to me, so. There's a lot of guys got that show on the phones when I was down there.
What's that?
When I was in Dave Letterman, they got it right on the phone.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, lots of them.
Like that?
And Dick or Ashman,
you know about
yeah.
That's it.
To Victoria Square. Now, folks, I know. I know that it's not fair to make fun of somebody's name, but good. Goslin? Bought everything with it? Absolutely. Tommy
here. Northgate Petro Canada. Oh, they're relocating their new office at Victoria Square.
That's nice, eh?
They're celebrating. Oh, via con Dios, Dick Assman. Via con Dios.
I like that, but that's the whole show, really. Does it show them two girls on there too?
I think so, yeah.
Oh, well.
Let's see.
I always told everybody that the reason they gave me two girls is because they figured one couldn't handle me, so.
So I think I read something that you had a bunch of marriage proposals.
Yeah, I had a couple of those too.
Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, they just phoned that and I just don't know.
No?
One lady from Toronto, she was gonna take me, drive me to New York when she heard that I was going down there.
And what did you say to her?
No.
No? Were you married?
Nope. Never married.
Never married?
No.
How come?
Well, I was married to the Grudge.
You were married to the what?
To the Grudge.
Oh.
Every day I was there. Never missed a day.
So this is the current location you're working at?
Yeah.
So give us a rundown. What are kind of some of your duties?
Well, it's all self-serve.
It's all self-serve?
Just run the till, you know, do cleanups and stuff like that.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Do you prefer the self-serve ones, or did you like pumping the gas?
Oh, I didn't mind pumping gas.
No. Yeah? No. What about in the wintertime?
I was okay.
Did you dress up warm?
Not really. I always got help for it. I never wear gloves in the wintertime.
No?
It's like self-serve. People come in, pump their own gas. They come in and pay for it, or they can pay it at the pumps.
Yeah? Do a lot of people come to this location in particular because they know you work here?
Oh, yeah. There's quite a few. I wouldn't deal here if I wouldn't be here.
How many times a day do you think you have somebody coming in, recognizing you, or coming in here just to see you?
Oh, once or twice, or two or three anyways.
Two or three times a day?
Oh, yeah. A lot of them, they take pictures of me.
How long have you been at this location for?
I was over south in there for quite a while. Been here now about a year now. But I worked here before and then moved over there for two years. And now they closed that, so I'm over here.
Well, there, you've been just going to Petro-Canada.
Yeah.
So Dick meets Dave. Dick Ass Mania.
I don't know if this will help you anything or not, but I...
Oh, absolutely, yeah, it's cool to have a look-see. Yeah, look, you look like the exact same 20 years ago. So any memories you have of any of this stuff?
Not really. Probably forgotten more than half, right?
Yeah, it's been a while, for sure.
Yeah.
What kind of time period were you collecting all these articles?
I didn't. A friend of mine did it.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
I never collected them all. Well, I got some at home there, but nothing.
Nothing like this?
Nothing like this.
Dick versus Canada's other tourist attractions. You're kind of like right, you're mixed in with like Peggy's Cove and West Edmonton Mall and the CN Tower.
Yeah.
So to come see you here in Regina is like a Canadian tourist destination. That's pretty cool. That's where you tossed Hitman Hart?
Yeah, that's right. You all flipped him, I'm sitting over here. Yeah. And look at the people there, eh?
Yeah, there's a lot.
Oh, yeah,
sure.
It was packed in there.
That must have been awesome to get to arm wrestle.
Oh, yeah. Oh, exactly, yeah.
Yeah. And Namath, Joe Namath?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's kind of crazy, you know, Namath was using your celebrity to get boost his. So yeah, from the pumps to the poles. So how did that work that, like you were being asked to like run for office kind of at one point in time?
Oh yeah, some guys figure I should go for prison stuff. Yeah, right.
you never thought of?
Well, you need education for that.
Not something you'd be interested in?
No.
Assman's fame tested. Letterman calls Saskatoon. Is that they were calling the Daisy restaurant?
Yeah.
Ginny, and answer this question honestly. Have you ever heard of a man named Dick Assman?
Dick Assman?
Yes.
No.
Have you ever eaten there in Saskatoon?
Yeah, well, that time I went to Saskatoon, that's where we went for dinner there. That night when he phoned, though, like I guess next day, they were just packed at Daisy's. They thought I was going to come down there, but I had no intention of going down there.
Oh, yeah.
You know, but they they phoned, and so when I went to start doing that university thing, and then we went over then.
Okay.
Well, this is the guy who was telling you, ambassador from.
From New York.
Yeah.
Yeah, that must have been surprising when
you
showed
up. Oh, I guess so. I guess so.
Yeah. So with all the people that have, that kind of came and seen you, or you went to see them during these appearances, who were you the most like starstruck by, or who were you the most taken back by?
Well, I would say this guy here. You know that that's something, boy. I think Blanchard was his name, was it?
James Blanchard. Yeah.
Yeah.
So he beat out like Bret Hitman Hart.
Yeah. Well, no, maybe not Letterman, but it's pretty close there. Eh?
Yeah. So looking back on all these articles now, are you surprised by the one article you put in the newspaper to kind of grow from that?
Well, exactly. Hey, especially when I had my name on there for about 26 years, a great big sign. Nobody said nothing, eh? And then all of a sudden, bang. It's unbelievable what one guy can do. He like let him get it going like that, eh?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just a few comments.
Exactly.
Yeah. When was like the ultimate height of your rise to celebrity, that song?
Well, that was shortly after he phoned me, or when I went down there, eh? Then she was hopping that.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And then for like a fall?
It lasted quite a while. Oh, yeah.
Yeah. And when did you kind of like be able to stand back and notice it was kind of like slowing down?
Probably a year later.
A year later?
Oh,
also
yeah.
So like summer of 96
Yeah, they're still, even now they're still coming in there.
So what do you think kind of keeps the ball rolling on this after so many years?
I don't know. Everybody likes it. A lot of people coming. When are you going back in the show, huh? When are you going back in the show?
Yeah.
I always thought it was sort of stupid, just a kind of name, make all this fuss. Wouldn't you think?
So do you think after all these years it's kind of kept you humble?
Well, probably, yeah.
Or what do you think has kind of kept you humble over all these years?
Actually, that's the way I've been right along, you know. Even when younger, you know, it's...
Fame isn't something that
No.
So has there ever been like a time throughout the past like 20 years or so where you're just kind of like, I just wish everyone would...
I'm never that way, no.
No?
No.
Well, this is one that, you want to hold on to that, Dick? You can have a look through.
Newspapers all over the United States. We came upon this little
advertisement
right here.
There's one of them. I'm not
sure which
one
it is. And we found it kind of interesting. It's Scott Goslin and Dick Assman, formerly of Northgate Petro Canada, have relocated and extended an invitation to our friends and guests to visit us at Victoria Square, Petro Canada. We were kind of taken by the man's name, Dick Assman. I don't know that I've ever met a guy named Assman.
Uh-huh.
Do you know what? Is Assman a Canadian name?
No, I don't know any Assman myself.
Yeah.
How do you do, Dick Assman? Nice to see you.
and Tony Orlando actually sang a song. Do we have that roll of videotape last night? Here's Tony Orlando singing.
Oh, vaya con Dios, Dick Assman.
We thought tonight, if we have a second, we'll just call and spend a minute or two here on the show getting to know Dick Assman. Here we go. Saskatchewan, I believe. I think Victoria Square, is that what it says? This should be somebody at Petro Canada, Victoria Square, Petro Canada. We're looking for Dick Assman. Scott Goslin.
Canada, Victoria Square Service. Scott speaking.
Oh, Scott, how are you? My name's Dave Letterman. Are you Scott Goslin?
Yes, Yes, I am.
Scott, it's a pleasure to chat with you on the phone. How are things there at the service station today?
Just great. Just booming.
Uh-huh. You know, the reason we're calling, Scott, we want to speak to your co-worker, or is it your partner?
Yeah, he's a co-worker here.
All right. Is Dick Assman?
Yes, yes.
I tell you, Scott, we would love to talk to you, but your name's not silly enough. So if you don't mind, if you could put Dick on the phone, we'd certainly appreciate it.
Could you hold the line a minute?
Yeah, I'll be happy to. I'm not doing anything else. Just waiting to pick up my laundry, Scott. Take all the time you need.
Hello.
Hello, who is this?
Dick Assman.
Oh, Dick! Dick, my name is Dave Letterman. It's a pleasure to chat with you, sir. How are you today?
Real good, real good.
You know, Dick, last night on our television show, The Late Show here on CBS, we featured a little ad for you and your service station, and we made some jokes about your name. I hope you don't mind.
No, I sure don't.
It's kind of an unusual name, though, isn't it?
Just like to know how you got a hold of it.
Yeah. Well, I think we can tell by looking at the photo how you got a hold of it. Dick?
61.
And Dick, tell us a little bit about what life is like up there. Are you in Saskatchewan?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. And what do you do for fun?
Well, I like horse races.
Uh-huh.
And I watch a lot of football and baseball and that.
Yeah? Well, there you go. You can't do any better than that, Dick. Well, will you do us a favor and keep in touch?
Okay.
And again, you pronounce your name how?
Assman.
Assman. All right. Thank you very much, Dick. Nice chatting with you.
Okay.
Bye-bye. Like a very nice man.
Lovely guy.
Up there in Saskatchewan, you ever been to Saskatchewan?
Never been out there.
It's a beautiful country.
Here it's great out there.
It's wheat country out there, isn't
it? That's right, prairie land.
And who knows, maybe one day we'll have Dick right here on the show.
What was the highlight of your whole experience?
Well, being on the Dave Letterman show, that's got to be the highlight.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah.
Since that whole event kind of happened, it's all unfolded. What do you take with you from that event in your everyday now?
Well, it's sort of easing off now, you know. It's put there for a while and, you know, it was pretty exciting. You know? But, you know, it's just like an ordinary day, I guess.
So what would you like our audience to know about that event?
Well, whatever happened, I enjoyed it, so.
No regrets?
No regrets.
Did you notice all Dick would not let go of my hand? We shook hands for about 40 minutes, and then I was finally able to break free, and then we shook hands again for another 20 minutes. And it just occurs to me, this guy pumps gas for a living. That's what he's always got a hold of that nozzle right there. We have to do a commercial. We'll be right back, ladies and gentlemen.
If you have program ideas that you'd like to see on Max TV Local On Demand, write us at max.local@sasktel.com. Max TV programming is now available on Max TV On The Go at maxtvonthego.sasktel.com.